Everyone has heard about the term fossil. Fossils are generally known as the remains of an organism or plant, but there is more to understand about the term. Do you know how fossils form? Do they just melt or suddenly come together? That's what the Brainghetti channel will reveal to you in this video. Keep your eyes glued to the video and give us a thumbs up. Now, let's start by explaining what fossils mean. Body. A fossil is the remains or traces of a dead organism, plant, or animal such as tissues, shells, teeth, or bones, and even bacteria. It can also be footprints or worm burrows that trace life and history. However, it is rare for living things to become fossilized because often after the death of animals, their body rots away without remains. But then, on special occasions, fossils can form. Most fossils form when the organism becomes a rock. Let's see how they form. 1. Mold and cast. These fossils form when the organism's original bone or tissue is removed by processes that occur after burial, such as groundwater flow. The impression can be in mold or cast. Cast occurs when the organism remains decomposed entirely, leaving a space just like the shape of the organism, the process where the minerals or sediment fill the hollow depression. But if minerals fill in this space and form a mineralized 3D shape of the organism, it is referred to as a mold, where a duplicate of a plant or animal is preserved in sedimentary rocks. The organism is buried in sediment and then dissolved by underground water, leaving a hollow depression. However, the mold shows only the original shape and marking of the organisms. It does not reveal the internal structure. Minerals or sediment fills the hollow depression and forms a cast. They are particularly useful to biologists who can use them to discover extinct animal species and history. 2. Permineralization. The most common method of fossilization is called permineralization, or petrification. Here, each part of the organism is replaced by minerals, leaving a stone copy of the organism. It occurs when water drips into the remains and minerals dissolved in the water drip into the spaces within the remains, where they form crystals. These crystallized minerals cause the remains to harden along with the encasing sedimentary rock. The original shell or bone becomes buried below the ground and water penetrates the surface. The groundwater contains the calcium carbonate that fills the empty spaces in the material, which over time hardens and fills the pores full of minerals, which in turn form a fossil. After an organism's soft tissues decay in sediment, the hard parts, particularly the bones, are left behind. Bones, teeth, and even woody plant materials such as trees usually remain in this manner. 3. Trace. This fossil's form usually show tracks that animals made while moving across soft sediment. This sediment later hardens to become sedimentary rock. Animal footprints were made in soft sediment that later formed solid sedimentary rock. There are three main types of trace fossils. Tracks and trails are produced by an organism walking, crawling, foraging, or resting. The traces can also be in the form of tracks like footprints and movement, animal trails made in soft sediment that later formed solid sedimentary rock. The structure of the animal or plant remains in a mineral form. The colors of the minerals that replace the form can be dazzling. Sometimes they're made into art and jewelry. Trace fossils are valuable to paleontologists because by studying these footprints, scientists can discover how the animals move, which in turn gives important information about the structure and even life of the species. 4. Preservation. Fossils can be intentionally preserved by humans. It can be found through unaltered fossils, and this type is rare except as captured in amber, trapped in tar, dried out, or frozen as a preserved woolly mammoth. Both ice and amber protect the organisms from decay and give them an oxygen-free environment. The entire animal has been preserved, even the soft parts, which usually decay and disappear. Fossils can also be replaced with shellfish and wood. Replacement is when the atomic composition of the original living thing is replaced cell by cell by a new chemical structure. Typically, the chemical that replaces the original is determined by the groundwater the fossil is living in. A common type of replacement, simplification. This is when the original living remains are replaced with silica, as in the case of petrified forests. 5. Carbonization. Carbonization generally means a chemical reaction where water transforms the organic material of a plant or animal into a thin film of carbon. organic materials like nitrogen, hydrogen, and oxygen are driven off as gases, leaving an outline of the organism. Organisms' fossils, often bicarbonization, include fish, leaves, and the woody tissues of plants. The remains of the plant or animal are crushed beneath the weight of the rock, leaving behind a carbon film, an impression of the former living thing. This fossil formation is the one in which the organism is formed as a residual, thin film of carbon instead of the original organic matter. The original organism results in thin layers of carbon or coal. What is left behind is a carbon film, an impression of the former living thing. One would have thought animals and plants just rot away after death. Fossils are an incredible phenomenon that can be unbelievable if not for the fact that it has been proven to be true. They are valuable to humanity, climate, and the atmosphere. Even paleontologists, scientists, and archaeologists use them as an instrument to trace the history of extinct animals like dinosaurs and to understand their behavior. That is why this channel brings to your knowledge incredible facts about the afterlife of plants and organisms. I hope you find this video fascinating. Do not forget to subscribe and hit the notification button to get updated when we post another interesting video. Thanks for watching.